Digvijay Singh does not blame Yasin Malik. We give 5 more minutes to this debate and I give one last opportunity to Mr. Kant. Now there is Yasin Malik who refers to the killers of the Kashmiri Pandits as our boys. Anupam Kher, this is a fact. Instead of talking about Jagmohan, should Mr. Digvijay Singh first have spoken about the role of Yasin Malik? And in your view, Mr. Kher, why is he not talking about Yasin Malik and talking about Jagmohan instead? Anupam Kher, please, and then we'll give Mr. Kant one more opportunity to respond. By the way, quick developments happening. Anup, I have another breaking story in a minute. Yes, please, Mr. Kher.
Arnab, I don't give any credit to Mr. Digvijay Singh to make a sane statement. So I don't want to get into this statement what he made, because it's only a person who is not there can make a statement like that. He also said about 2611 people. He keeps talking about he should
settle
down
in a neighboring
country and sort of whatever he wants to do. My point is, after all these years, 25 years in exile, 25 years in being a refugee, what has happened? We are still trying to convince Mr. Kant, who is a fellow Indian, to know it was not Jagmohan. It was the atrocities of millions of lakhs of people outside banging doors with these mashals, with guns, everything telling, get out of this place, leave your women behind, Kashmiri Pandits, and go away from here. I have my personal equation, my personal relatives have gone through this. What is he talking about? Is he, what is wrong with them? What is wrong with our Indians of our own community, our own people? What are they talking about? Malab, I go beyond, it's beyond my comprehension that I have to convince a person that what you are saying is wrong, what your leader has said is absolutely wrong. And your leader should shut his mouth off if he can't say anything which is nice.
Okay, so one last time. If a self-goal has been committed, apologize and move on. But to defend it partially or completely is unacceptable, Mr. Kant. Lot of people watching NewsHour tonight. You do not blame Pakistan. You don't blame the terrorists first. You first blame Jagmohan. And you on the show say that statement has partial truth. You want to withdraw it on the party's behalf or apologize on your party's behalf? One last opportunity, Mr. Kant, if you choose to take it.
Mr. Arnab Goswami, I would like to categorically tell you that you are misrepresenting what I said to your viewers. I said that it is a complex situation in which Pakistan, the militants, the terrorists, and the
it is not a complex shameful.
It is shameful. That you place the Indian state and the terrorists at the same level.
Why are you not letting me complete? Because you are placing the Indian state and terrorists at the same level.
That's why. One second. Nalin Kohli responding 2 minutes on the debate.
I am not placing the Indian state. I am talking about
that cocktail of terrorism was scripted in Pakistan.
Mr. Kant, may I please make a point?
I am blaming the
jihadists. Let me please make a point. Then you can,
but
Mr.
let
Kant,
me tell you
Mr.
categorically
Kant,
that there was there a perception. Hang, let me, Nalin,
Mr.
I will
Kant,
not intervene when you speak. Let me complete. Mr. Nalin Kohli, let me just complete my sentence. I never intervene when you speak. The fact of the matter is, I have said categorically that it is Pakistan, it is the jihadis, the terrorists, and the perception that the state administration was going to take a very hard line against terrorists, most of whom were Muslims at that point of time, that made the Kashmiri Pandits leave. And there is no doubt that a national consensus should be built on Kashmiri Pandits. And you must answer, Mr. Nalin Kohli, why in the 6 years that you were in power, why did you not get the Pandits back? I hope Mr. Arnab Goswami confronts you with this question.
Now may I answer, if your speech to the nation is coming to an end, Mr. Khan, perhaps for variety, some other voices may be heard.
As far as variety, I'm sure you can write a book on it. Please do, but now I'd like to say I've had enough of this.
May I just make my point, please? Number one, as political persons, we all are used to speaking in matters of grey. Mr. Kant, I'm sorry.
Mr. Kant, please, you asked the question. Let him answer.
Oh, Mr. Goswami, can you pull then, that gag? Can you pull
yes,
that
please.
Mic
no,
down?
No, please. One second.
This can't be a monologue.
No, there's no need
Kant
for gags, please. Mr. Kohli, continue.
Digvijay Singh. Okay, yeah. So, let's go one. First of all, as political people, many of us learn to speak in grey without being black and white. But on national and human tragedies, there can't be ifs and buts.
The world lives in grey, bottom,
simply
black and white.
A or B.
That is the first
in this case, there cannot be. There cannot be any justification for the statement that Mr. Digvijay Singh has said. It's completely condemnable. It's anti-national. Number two, Mr. Digvijay Singh has basked in the glory of being Mr. Rahul Gandhi's so-called political guru. That's the topmost as the vice president who's perceived to see that we become the president of the Congress party. He has called Osama bin Laden Osama Ji. So is this what the thinking of the Congress party is? And that's why it is preventing any action against Mr. Digvijay Singh. We've seen his views always on such matters. Number three, the true winners of this entire story are the real voters in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, across Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh and Leh, Kargil, who braved the bullets, who braved the calls against voting by the separatists and went out and voted.
By the way,
they are not sitting in Daman and Diu. They are not sitting. They are not sitting in their Daman and Diu, tweeting away just to make themselves relevant in the media and say the most outrageous anti-national things, as Mr. Digvijay Singh has said today.
Well, I have breaking news coming in. I have to hate to break this up, but I have breaking news coming in. I have Navika Kumar on the line. 1 second, please. Let's go to the breaking news. Now, Navika, is it certain that Bedi's naming is being announced? Please stay on with us. Nalin Kohli, Mr. Khan, don't go away. Is it certain Kiran Bedi's name is being announced as chief ministerial candidate? And why this announcement seems to be a change of mind?
Well, it is very clear the BJP may make a departure from its earlier norms of not announcing a chief ministerial candidate, as in the case of the Haryana, Jharkhand and Maharashtra polls. This time they may announce Kiran Bedi as the chief ministerial candidate. We understand that decision has been taken in the parliamentary board that met just a little while ago. What we do understand is Kiran Bedi is likely to join Amit Shah in the BJP headquarters in a little while from now. She is currently campaigning somewhere near Rohini. And once she comes there, the announcement could be made. The reason we understand, Arnav, is one, the momentum of the party will be given to Kiran Bedi, because so far the party has appeared confused as to who will be the face of the Delhi BJP, and it wants to now take forward Kiran Bedi and use that face to an advantage.
Right.
The second, of course, is to kill the dissent. And the flip side is it also distances Narendra Modi from any adverse
result
of the Delhi elections that could come up in this tight contest between the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP.
Okay, very quick reactions here. Change of heart. Nalin Kohli, BJP getting nervous now? Is this the idea? Eventually make it Kiran Bedi versus... Is Kiran Bedi... sorry to, you know, jump this story on you, but is Kiran Bedi versus Arvind Kejriwal a better bet than Narendra Modi versus Arvind Kejriwal, which is the way it was looking?
Well, Mr. Narendra Modi and Mr. Kejriwal have had a face-off. It was just about 7-8 months ago in Varanasi. We know the result. And there has been a complete face-off on that. So that face-off has already taken place.
No, but
you
it's
don't
a
have
safe
face-offs
strategy
on a day-to-day basis. That's one part.
Mr. Kant is...
Second is, I'm going to wait. I'm going to go
wait
for the parliamentary board announcement.
Sure.
Because this news may not be correct, predict it. Yeah.
Okay, sure. This is what we are hearing. It may change of position. We're getting some pictures. The announcement can happen. Mr. Kant wants to come in and say something here. By the way, there is obviously a big announcement.
Yeah,
I don't think at 10:42 p.m., in the BJP headquarters, 11 Ashoka Road, where you spend a large part of your day, that suddenly there would be this big press conference which were to be called if it were not to be for a big announcement. So we can be quite clear it's a big announcement. The whole thing in place is being spruced up. There must be some sense of urgency why this announcement is being made. It can't just be because a list of candidates is being announced. You can just release the list to the media. Something big is happening tonight, Mr. Kant. And the general expectation is that Kiran Bedi could be formally appointed the chief ministerial candidate or the chief ministerial face, so as also to end all the sort of internal wrangling that's going on in the BJP, Mr. Kant. So this totally, you know, edges the Congress party out. It becomes to a personality battle. I don't think, you know, Ajay Makan features in that, unless your party will do that. But Rahul Gandhi doesn't even like doing that.
Arnab, I'd like to say two things. First, I'd like to just finish off with Mr. Nalin Kohli's thing about referring to Mr. Digvijay Singh as Mr.
Rahul. Let's move on from that. There's a big story happening here.
Does not have a mentor. Okay. Now, as far as the Delhi elections goes, the fact of the matter is that it is the nervousness of the BJP 15 days, 20 days prior to the elections, which is making them make the media people wait outside their office at 10:45 p.m. If they have to make a decision about Ms. Kiran Bedi, it could have been tomorrow, it could have been 10 days earlier. The fact that she's been parachuted shows that there is complete nervousness in the BJP. There's lack of leadership.
Nervousness about what?
Who have served the party for the last 30-40 years.
Nervousness
about losing. They do not want. There's nervousness that the existing leadership cannot lead the party to victory. We believe Ms. Kiran Bedi cannot lead the party to victory. And please remember that most of the media had got it wrong about Delhi. Mr. Nalin Kohli forgets the difference between Varanasi and Delhi. There's a big difference between Varanasi and Delhi. And the fact of the matter is that most of the surveys had given less than 5 seats to Aam Aadmi Party during the 2013 elections.
Why are you arguing for the Aam Aadmi Party?
So do not.
Why are you pitching?
No,
for this?
I am not arguing.
Suspicious.
I am saying
Mr.
so.
Khan
do not.
I know.
Mr. Khan is arguing for everyone except the Congress.
Mr. Khan is arguing for everyone except the Congress.
Let me finish.
Have you heard Mr. Gandhi's name?
I said this is the surprise that the Congress is going to spring who you are writing away, because you wrote away the Congress. You said this. I said that is the sort of surprise that the Congress is going to.
He's even sad that there are media people at the BJP office and not at the Congress office. This is so funny, Mr. Kant. I must say, so it's really funny.
It doesn't matter. You might find it funny. Your sense of humor may be a bit retarded. I cannot comment on it. But all I am saying is that I was responding
Mr.
to Mr. Arnab Goswami saying,
"Have a glass of water."
Where he says,
"Have a glass
one
of
second,
water."
Let me
the
complete,
only retarded
let me
comment came from Mr. Digvijay Singh.
No. I do not need any advice from you on when to have a glass of water or not. I am certainly capable of looking after myself when I need water or not. If you need some water of vodka which is lying around you, you may certainly have
please.
It. Because you are welcome to have your glass of vodka.
Excuse me. One minute. Hold on. Wait a minute. What kind of rubbish is happening here? How dare you allude that I'm drinking alcohol here? That may be your habit. Maybe that's an imported habit that you're getting from some kind of leaders from outside the country. How dare you allude me like that? Don't you dare reduce this to any kind of debate. No one, I don't care whether you drink or not. But how dare you allude that I'm having alcohol in a serious political discussion? This is not how the BJP Karyakarta works on television.
I don't know.
And I take strong offense to it. All the rest of it. No, it's none of your business. How dare you allude to it?
Kind
of vodka, whiskey and all this, you want to do it, but don't you dare allude it to me, Mr. Khan. I'm not going to tolerate it. You can call Mr.
You can say Mr.
Digvijay Singh's statement is acceptable. Then you might extend it to drinking alcohol. This is not done. Don't you dare. I expect an unconditional apology for that, Mr. Khan. I do expect that unconditional apology. I do expect an unconditional apology. We are not a part of a party of drunkards like this. And how dare you? You are drunk with power, and you're not over with that drunken power spree of yours, and that's why you're making such loose comments.
If that was an innocuous remark, take it back. Don't make it a big deal. One second. 1 minute. No, 1 second. When Mr. Kohli, you've registered your protest, and Mr. Kant, I'm sure you did not mean it in the way Mr. Kohli has understood, but he has a right to feel upset. So, anyway, that's not the issue. The issue tonight is we are 12 minutes to 11 p.m., and there is some tremendous action happening in the BJP headquarters. We are told Kiran Bedi may be reaching
Mr.
in any
Goswami,
few minutes.
All I was saying was
a big announcement could be happening.
You said that
Mr. Kant, a big what the BJP is saying is at least there's some action in the BJP office. I don't know what is happening in the Congress party.
Absolutely,
office. There is something
Mr. Goswami,
going on there.
All
today.
I was commenting so was you think, that you said
Mr. Goswami,
you said that this
there,
rights
please.
Of the Congress, and
the
I said this does
request.
Not right of the Congress. I said the way the Aam Aadmi Party was written off in 2013 November, the Congress, which is being written off by you right now, is.
I am not writing anyone off. I am
of
saying. I am simply saying tonight that there is a big, almost midnight press conference happening. If Kiran Bedi lands up at the BJP office, then one thing, Nalin Kohli, you will have to accept. That there has been an unnatural haste, almost an emergency action. I'm sure even you did not expect this press conference to happen because, you know, most people did not know about it. If it is happening, people will ask you, why is it suddenly happening? Is it because you want to...
Well, I've been the media convener of the BJP for a few years.
You didn't know about this.
Goswami, actually, we've had the BJP president. No, I didn't know about it. I'm sitting here. Certainly, I cannot know about the developments taking place somewhere else. But yes, Ms. Bedi has come into the party. It's a big announcement for us. We are happy about it that she wants to work in the direction that the BJP and Prime Minister Modi has been speaking of. Development and meeting the aspirations of the people. It's a positive agenda. With regard to organizing press conferences, as a former media convener of the party, I've had the party president come and address press conferences as late as 11:30. It's happened in the past, so it's not the first time. If Ms. Bedi arrives, as you are saying, certainly it would be considered that it's a big announcement related to Ms. Bedi. That's a possibility you can speculate on. Okay. But I will hold myself and I will wait for the final announcement before I make a comment.
Sure. As of now, this is what we know. Kiran Bedi is likely to be there at the BJP office. We are hearing about a possible announcement, but I go with what Nalin Kohli says. Let the announcement happen. It's a developing story. Keep your channel switched on to Times Now. Keep staying on, stay on with our channel. I'm only closing the news hour tonight. These two breaking stories, including, by the way, Shashi Tharoor's line of questioning, exactly what he's being asked. Two big breaking stories tonight, by the way. Shashi Tharoor is still being questioned and Kiran Bedi could be the chief ministerial face. Well, you never know when the news day becomes even more exciting. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining me on that interesting chat. Thank you.